we need to talk about the unreleased Hyperland Premium. Whilst I don't use Hyperland right now, as I've said in many videos, I'm making use of Neri at this moment. My drive is almost full. I will deal with that later. There is a lot of just misinformation and straight up lies floating around about Hyperland Premium. And this is the page. There's not much information here, but we'll get to the information in just a bit. Supercharge your Hyperland experience. Desktop, forums, and more from the Hyperland team for you. Now, when you hear something like premium, your mind might immediately go to, oh, it's not gonna be open source anymore. Oh, there's gonna be features locked behind a paywall. Oh, something malicious, something bad is going on. Is this maybe a scammer? Is something weird happening? Well, it's obviously not a scammer because it's on the Hyperland domain, and Vaxery, the developer of Hyperland, has been constantly talking about Hyperland Premium ever since people realized the page was public. It's very much a work in progress. But this is real. It should be very obvious it's a work in progress because if you click on the login button, okay, maybe not login button. If you click on the sign up button, it literally tells you you can't sign up yet because it's a work in progress and people just don't read because reading is hard. Being a work in progress, it is subject to change. What is written here isn't necessarily the way it's going to be when it is fully available, but it does give us a baseline to work from. So, does this mean that Hyperland is no longer free software? Does this mean that it having a permissive license this entire time was a trap? It was a way to get you to use Hyperland and embrace, extend, extinguish, it's gonna become evil now. Does this mean we need to fork Hyperland and make Hyperlibre? Well, I wanna ask you a couple of very simple questions, okay? Let's talk about a few projects. So, is KDE free software? Is GNOME free software? Is Elementary OS free software? In this case, it's literally called purchase. Oh my god, you're buying something. That must mean it's not free software. If your answer is yes, none of these are free software, please get your head checked because they're all free software. Firstly, this is the most important part. Charging for FOSS is not a violation of any license. Not even the GPL. There is a page on the FSF website about specifically this. Many people believe that the spirit of the GNU project is that you should not charge money for distributing copies of software, or that you should charge as little as possible, just enough to cover the cost. This is a misunderstanding. Actually, we encourage people who redistribute free software to charge as much as they wish or can. If a license does not permit users to make copies and sell them, it is a non-free license. If this seems surprising to you, please read on. You can sell free software. This is why I've never liked the word free. Libre should have been the term used from the very beginning. Much more importantly though, in these three cases, you're not actually buying anything. Yes, it's called purchase in the case of Elementary OS, but you can just put zero here, and basically what you are doing is you are donating to the project. It's just in the case of Elementary OS, the donation is built into the download prompt. And in these cases, you're definitely not buying anything because you're literally just donating to the project with nothing in return. Now, the Hyperland case is also just a donation. It's just a donation where you also happen to get something in return. What do you get? Again, work in progress, so things are absolutely subject to change. If we go to pricing/donate, right here we have Hyperland Premium. Coming soon, Hyperland Premium is a paid subscription unlocking our paid services like Desktop Experience Premium coming soon and allowing you to access premium-only parts of the forums for support straight from the developers, private Q&A, and more. So, your donation supports development, you get access to the premium part of the forums and premium desktop experience. What does premium desktop experience actually mean? Because this part is pretty self-explanatory. You have the premium forums, which is a separate part of the forums, then the regular forums. Makes sense. But premium desktop experience. I've seen some people saying, oh, this means there's going to be features locked behind a paywall. You can only get them if you have the premium version of Hyperland. I do think Hyperland Premium as a name isn't really the best idea. I don't know something better, but I think Premium gives people a bad perception of what it's going to be. Because literally all it means is just dot files. That's all it means. It just means dot files you're going to get if you pay for them. Maybe he'll get bored and make a custom Arch ISO or a custom Arch install script that only you get if you pay for Hyperland Premium. But that's it. It's just additional things on top of Hyperland that are not just part of the main project, but it's not any additional functionality. As for the future premium-only services, I'll get more to that in just a moment. Now, if we scroll down, there are also the general donations as well. At this point, these do currently work as these link over to Ko-fi, so if you want to donate to the project, you can do that over there. Here, you support development, you get a supporter badge, and a mention in the Hyperland release notes. If you're a monthly donator, you get the monthly supporter badge, one-time Hyperland release notes mention, and if you donate more than 20 euros a month, you will get a recurring mention. I've also seen confusion about there being a terms of service and a privacy policy. Oh my god, does this mean that if you break the rules of Hyperland, you're going to be banned from using Hyperland? No, no, there's a terms of service here because there's an account system and the privacy policy because there's an account system and there's a terms of service because there's a forum. And if you break the rules of the forum, you could get banned from the forum because, you know, he can't have you hosting, you know, illegal material on the forum. That, like, that's just like, you need to have a set of criteria to remove people if they're doing things you don't want them to be there. It has nothing to do with the Hyperland desktop itself. Why is there a Hyperland Premium? Why is this something that Vax3 wants to make? Well, let's go to the About section. Scroll down just a bit. Who manages Hyperland and the account? It's all still managed by me, Vax3. No greedy shareholders, no unfair practices, just great software for you. The reality is brutal. In order for me to produce great software, I also need to eat, have a place to sleep, and have electricity. Ideally, I'd also love to employ a few people to help me down the road. All of this is made with the goal of making that possible. Hyperland has grown way, way bigger than anybody would have expected. Right now, it is basically the go-to compositor if you don't want to have a desktop environment on Wayland. Like, that's pretty much the way it goes. For a long time, it was Sway. And Sway's great, don't get me wrong, but Hyperland filled a niche that people really wanted. They wanted something that was really customizable. They wanted a dynamic tiler. They wanted features to be adopted considerably quicker. And Hyperland's basically done everything there. Contrary to popular belief, developers are people. I know, right? A, like, crazy idea. And you know what? People have bills. They have things they want to buy. And maybe want to hire people and expand the project. And there is nothing wrong with people making money in the FOSS world. Just because you're doing something FOSS does not mean you have to have negative money. It does not mean that it just has to be a hobby. It does not mean it can't become something more than that. So many projects out there that people rely on today that are now really big projects, they started as a small hobby project. Over time, they got adopted by more people, more developers joined on, they got more donations, and now they are the, like, massive projects that we all rely on. That's okay. Like, making money is not inherently a bad thing. Literally, the only problem is that literacy is at an all-time low. People read premium, and that's where they stop reading. This got shared around in various subreddits, people talking about it, a lot of people getting angry, some people not reading it, other people actually reading it, understand what is being written here. Just have a read of these Reddit comments and and just enjoy them. I'll leave this thread linked down below. This became so much of a problem, even though this hasn't even been publicly announced yet, right? Like, it was shown in a live stream, and it's been up for like a month or so. It's not even publicly available to sign up for yet, but because it's been getting so much attention, Vax3 had to go and directly address it. Is it real? Yes. It's the official website, and it did not get hacked. Hyperland is not going source. As it says right here on the support page. Scroll down just a bit. Hypeland and will always stay free and open source software. Donating is purely voluntary. We will never lock features behind a paywall. This one. Why money? Again, I explain that. Now, as for the further premium services, a general catch-all clause, if any premium services come out in the future, they will most likely just be part of the premium subscription. This might be .file sync or other ideas we don't know yet. That's why we didn't say. I wouldn't say anything at all because people are going to expect this as like a promise if you mention literally anything. But yeah, again, nothing is going to be locked behind a paywall that you actually care about. The only thing is premium configuration files that are pre-made. Premium pre-made dot files. That is all. Nothing else. People got angry about this because they saw premium and money and bad and subscription, and I get it, right? Like, you see premium, you see subscription, brain goes to the worst place possible. But there's nothing bad happening here at all. And the second that anything bad does happen, I will be the one to talk about it because I've done that many times before. I have no problem criticizing Hyperland if I see some sort of problem that does exist. Right now, though, there's no problem. If you like the projects you use and you have money to do so, please donate to them. I'm not going to tell you what projects to donate to. Donate to whatever ones you like. Give them money, help support them. If you can't do that, talk about them, you know, let people know they exist. And if you can, help out with development, do all that fun stuff. But there's nothing wrong with a subscription donation. That's all this is. It's a subscription donation. That's it. Anyway, if you liked the video, go like the video. If you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here where you can subscribe with money to the channel, Patreon, subscribe to the LiberaPay link in the description down below. We also have YouTube members. I never mentioned those, but those do exist as well. If you... No. That's gonna be it for me. Bye. Peace out. Bye.